During this pandemic time, thank you, Messrs. President, for the protection of our community here at St. Regis. For continued protection, we ask that you wear a mask, especially if you are in the high-risk category. Please sanitize your hands before receiving Holy Communion and follow social distancing. Please note that the body of Christ will be distributed with a hand only. In accordance with the latest government, 2 square meter social distancing regulations, the maximum number able to attend any mass at St. Regis could be 350 persons only. Please also note that for funeral, memorial services, and wedding, a maximum of 300 people only are able to attend, subject to the 2 square meter rule. Booking for Sunday masses remains essential. Good morning and welcome to our palace at St. Regis. If any of you are carrying a mobile phone, could I ask that you switch it off or turn it to silent? Thank you. This weekend, the liturgy celebrates the second Sunday of Lent. We welcome our parish children who are preparing for their first reconciliation.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everybody. So welcome to this morning celebration as we celebrate the second Sunday of Lent. First of all, we would like to welcome our candidates for the Sacrament of Reconciliation. Let us put hands together for them. So Lent is the time to make a spiritual transformation. Lent is the time to make a spiritual transfiguration. We pray today that the good Lord may help us really to use this opportunity to make this spiritual transformation, a change in our lives. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and acknowledge our failures, and so ask for forgiveness before the Lord. Lord Jesus, you call us to turn back to you. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you urge us to repent and seek forgiveness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, only you are our comfort and healing. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And during this Mass, we pray for Bernadette Coelho and her husband Emmanuel Pascal, that the good Lord may receive their souls. And we pray also for Jose Guerreiro, who died yesterday, that the good Lord may grant him an eternal repose. And also we pray for Sesto Marinozzi, that the good Lord also may receive these souls. Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with the spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
And took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. He said, Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this, and have not withheld your son, your only son. I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies. And by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessings for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice. The word of the Lord. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I trusted even in my head. I'm sorry afflicted. Oh, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful.
Dalla lettera di San Paolo Apostolo ai Romani. Carissimi, se Dio è per noi, chi sarà contro di noi? Egli non ci ha risparmiato il proprio figlio, ma lo ha consegnato per tutti noi. Non ci donerà forse ogni cosa insieme a lui? Ci muoverà accusi contro coloro che Dio ha scelto. Dio è colui che giustifica. Chi condannerà? Gesù Cristo è morto, anzi è risorto, sta alla destra di Dio e intercede per noi. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, "This is my beloved son. Listen to him." Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord. So, my brothers and sisters, welcome once again to St. Bridget, and we know there are some who are new here. We welcome you, really. And today, the second Sunday of Lent, our reflection is move from pain to gain. Move from pain to gain. Lent is a time to make a spiritual transformation, a time to change from the life of sin to a life of grace. That is a move from pain to gain. God's plan for human beings, when he created this world and made man the principle of being in it, was to share his own eternal happiness with him. But this plan of God was interfered by sin, which made people forget God and their purpose in life. The time of Lent is for helping us to move from being disloyal to God because of our sinful state to being loyal. Lent offers us an opportunity to move and leave our past behind and start a new life, a life of grace, a life of good relationship with God and with our brothers and sisters. Lent invites us to move from pain to gain. In the first reading, Abraham is tested by God for the second time. Abraham's first test was for him to leave his own country and his father's house and go to the unknown country that God promised to show him. This was not an easy thing to accept. It was so painful because in the days of Abraham, to leave one's tribal and one's relative was to risk one's life. But Abraham accepted this painful test, and as a result, he became the father of the nation. He moved from pain to gain. Abraham's second test of obedience and trust, of which we have just heard, is even more severe trial than the first one. He was asked to give up forever his only real son, Isaac. There were two reasons which made it so difficult for Abraham to obey. First, He loved his only son as a father who begot a son in his old age could love. And secondly, how could he be the father of a great race if his only son was put to death? That was how Abraham was pondering in his heart. However, Abraham's love of God overcame his natural love for his son, and his firm faith in the power of God told him that God could still find a way to fulfill the promise which he had made to him in his pagan homeland. This was the time when Abraham was passing through pain, but later Abraham became the father of a great race. He moved from pain to gain. In the gospel, we hear about the transfiguration of Jesus. Jesus took three of his disciples, Peter, James, and John, to a high mountain. And there he gave them a glimpse of the glory which was his. The appearance of Jesus was changed completely. He had become someone entirely different, someone glorious. And Jesus, at that instance, was talking to Moses and Elijah about his passion and death. This indicates that before attaining that glory, Jesus had to pass through passion and death. He had to move from pain to gain. There is no Easter without Good Friday. Today, then, we are invited to undergo a spiritual transfiguration, or rather a spiritual transformation that will help us move from pain to gain, from the state of sin to a state of grace, from a state of suffering to a state of glory. Sometimes in life, there are things that we cling to, and it is not easy to leave them. It is so painful to make a change in life. Pope Francis, during this time of Lent, is inviting us to make this transformation of life, even if it is painful, in order to gain. He says, I quote, "During Lent, let us change from sadness and be filled with gratitude, from anger and be filled with patience, from pessimism and be filled with hope, from grudges and be reconciled, from bitterness fill our hearts with joy, from hurting words and say kind words." That is a transformation. It is very difficult to really make those kind of changes, but we are invited to do so that it is painful, but later we will attain, or we will gain the glory. We will gain eternal life. So today, my brothers and sisters, let us thank God, our divine Lord, for giving us this consoling and encouraging vision of glory, that if we persevere in our struggles against the world, the flesh, and the devil, this struggle, of course, is not easy for our weak nature, but our loving Savior is ever beside us to raise us up and tell us not to fear. If we rely on him, we are invited to listen to his voice, which is always calling us, come and learn from me. Let us pray today that, encouraged by the vision of transfiguration, we may be strengthened in faith, just like how it was intended by Jesus to strengthen the faith of his disciples. Amen.
With their parents, together with the paper, don't forget the paper.
Let us, we are invited to pay attention to listen to our candidate as they make their promise in front of the sanctuary, in front of Jesus, that they will continue with the actions for the sacrament of reconciliation. So I invite our candidate to start reading together. Let's hold it. Okay, Good. Very good. They have already made their commitment. So let us put hands together for them. Thank you very much. Now there is a place for parent commitment. Now it is the time for the parents to make a commitment in front of the of Jesus. So thank you very much for the parents. Also, let us put hands together for assisting even their kids. So thank you very much. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you very much, and we continue to encourage you to continue with the instructions so that at the end you receive this very important sacrament for the church. So thank you very much. And thank you for the parents for continuing assisting these kids in this journey of faith. Thank you very much. Okay, let's finish. Let us stand for the prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, from the temptations in the wilderness to glory on the mountaintop, Jesus is always the one we listen to. Your divine favor rests on your only Son, Jesus Christ. Hear our prayer and give us your power to receive the words of your Son as the true light and glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and the purifying of their hearts, that, freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift we pray by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this," Jesus said, "in memory of me." Of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Anton, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Bridget, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And joyfully, let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take.
My brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him, takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are to be saved.
Thank you.
you to please sanitize the area where you are sitting before you leave. The rubbish bin is located at the back and outside the church. Thank you.
This is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Let us pray. As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us, while still on earth, to be partakers even now of the things of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in the peace of Christ. And please have a lovely day. Thanks.